misbehaving thing of object that you might be able to think of.
What is that called? I didn't see it. Oh, that's the card.
Show the card to everybody. I'll turn around. I'll turn back. Can I turn back?
Yes.
Okay, give me the card. I'm just going to stick the card in the different. See, if these cards were marked, they'd get unmarked right now. The pins are not marked, because I think they are. They're all wrong. Okay, now you want me to find your card really quick.
Wrong.
One of these two.
No.
Hold on.
Before the end.
Oh, I see what went wrong. Oh, I see what happened.
It's a trick him, David,
oh,
huh?
Oh, sorry. Now look. I gotta do it again. My card wouldn't find me.
Careful. Okay.
Okay, give me the card. I didn't see it. Give me the card upside down. Okay, inside it goes.
Inside it goes.
Shuffle.
Round and round and round. Wherever he touches it, wherever it goes.
Andrea!
Yay! That's love! Okay.
One, two, three, four, five. Now touch this. One, two, three, four, five. No, just touch this.
One, two, three, four, five.
Good boy. Now, watch what happens. Oh, I shouldn't have done that.
Remember what?
Oh, well, next trick. Tell me with this trick.
Okay, you'll help him with this trick?
Yeah. That trick messed up. I have my empty book, right? Is there any stamps in it?
You can send them here.
Don't worry, it's not okay. It's okay, nothing's gonna happen. Magic. Empty book. Okay? Now I have my stamps.
He's gonna put them in.
Now put them in. Inside my book. Open up, book. Okay, now, I need you to open up the fan, okay, and wave it over. Open up the fan. Open.
It's not that easy.
Okay, and wave it over. And it's... What happened? I said open up the fan so it's not broken. See, it's not broken. Wave it over, okay? Open up the fan.
You just broke it again.
Open up the fan. Open it. Open it the whole way. Wave it over! And!
Wait.
What happened? Sarah, get over! I told you I don't want you to come put up here. You can do it yourself. Open the fan, okay? Open the fan. Wave it over! Wave it over! Yay! Yeah, look what you did!
You made it fall!
Not fall, she'll say something.
You didn't say?
Not me!
Behind you! See, I need a big helper. A good boy helper standing right here. Or else this trick isn't going to work. Standing right here.
Hello?
Face camera. What's
your name? Someone raising his hand.
Stand right here. No.
David.
What?
He had a turn and he didn't have a turn.
He had a turn?
No, I didn't.
Oh, yeah, he did.
Well,
Daddy didn't have a turn, did he?
Daddy had a turn yesterday.
And nobody didn't have a turn today.
Don't worry, okay? I have a string. I have something wrong with my string, too. String's supposed to come out more. Okay, ball, right? Putting the ball inside. Ball's coming outside. Putting the ball inside. The ball's coming outside. Putting the ball inside. The ball's coming outside. Oh, guess where the ball is, Ayo? Where is it? In here? Wrong. Come on.
You have two of them.
And stick this in my hand.
I have the two.
Hmm?
I have the two.
What hand is it in? What hand's my ball in, Tiny Tom Tom?
What hand's my ball in? My ball's not in that hand. Another one. And you have one hand left.
Take the other one.
I asked for a ball. They give me a square. I asked for a square. They give me a ball. Thank you.
I have a trick.
Hello. Where's your hand? I like this hand. Come here.
make it into a coin.
Shh. Dollar.
Danny Zeus. Oh, okay, okay.
I turn it. I turn it over the magic one, number one.
Yeah. Number two, number three, number four, number
quiet. I turn it over the magic number one, two times. I turn this over. I fold it. Thank you. One, two, three. I close it. One, two, three, four. Now, I need you to tap your hand. One, two, three. First tap it once for the magic one.
One.
Now two for the magic two. Not too hard.
Two.
Now
three.
Now three. One, two, three. Not too hard.
One, two, three.
And now that's four. This four. One. One, two, three, four. Two, three, four. I got you. Okay, now watch how you lose money.
Move, Danny.
Danny, gotta move.
You lose it or you get a different
one. You lose money.
Magic.
You still that's how my mother over here loses money so quickly.
Oh, I like this one. Time out.
The mother of the
magician. Now all the guys wearing the same outfit, please stand. Please sit.
עכשיו אם אתה עושה, המג'ישן יעשה שהאימא תיעלם.
I'm gonna make mommy disappear. Where's Simba?
I don't know, I don't care. Mom, can you please not sit there, and can you please not sit there? With the magic hat. Somebody took my magic hat. Put it on. Too bad, it doesn't fit. Okay, so now, I put the dog inside this magic box.
You did now, this one yesterday.
I don't care what I did yesterday. Put it in that cooler, in that cooler. No,
me.
Oh,
me.
Me.
I
me.
I put it with Benjamin.
Army time.
My, me.
Come here.
Good job, David.
Open it the way I should. Open up the van. Open it. Wait over. Place it over here. And there. Please sit down. You're not my assistant.
Hey.
No way.
I'm going to do a trick.
So what? You did
yesterday.
Open it up.
I don't care what I did yesterday.
Wave it over. Open it up. Open it up. Open it up. Wave it over. That is three times. What's the manager? Whoop. I miss my nap, so. Oh, okay, now sit down. Now I take my top off. I'm trying to get it off. And I show you that the box is totally empty.
I know it is.
Totally bogus. I have piece one.
It's
you
in
sit
in
down.
Even if you know, you don't say it.
The dragon that helped me so much, and the rest of the box. Thank you.
What a barbarian stuff. Come on, ultimate warrior. Let's go.
Guy.
Well, bottle and don't move.
He's going to get up or he's going to get your hair.
No, well, he meant
she'll just suck it out whatever's left. Maybe she dripped something.
No wall over there. Yeah, don't throw the ball.
Danny's a Lego.
Danny, come over to me. I need you.
No. What?
Your germs are mean to yourself.
Yeah, that you can keep.
Camp Holly, 28 ביולי 1991, באנו לבקר את סימי, את דיוויד, אבל סימי משחק ואבי וסימי שפה משחקים בייסבול. Hey, Simi, how are you? Avi, תן חיוך. סמייל. אוקיי, גמרנו להיום? אוקיי. יש לנו דני, וסטיב, ולינדה, ופאפי. ודייוויד, הנה הוא דייוויד, חזר אלינו דייוויד. תוריד את הכובע שנראה אותך רגע. תוריד את הכובע. זה דייוויד, יופי. הנה מאמי אוכלת. מאמי, תאכלי משהו, מאמי. יש לה מאמי תינוק בבטן, היא אוכלת. צריכה להאכיל את התינוק, מאמי. יש לנו פה עוד, יש לנו פה אנדריה. אופ, 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 הלכה. הנה לינדה, ממלי, הנה מאמה, הכינה לנו סנדוויצ'ים, והנה עידית, והנה אפי, יס אפי, חייך, חייך, סמייל, אוקיי, איפה עידית? עידית? תני לנו חיוך סטייליסטי ככה, ככה בהפוכי כזה, עידית. חכי וחייכי בסטייל, עידית. סימי, אימא אמרה, איפה אימא? אימא אמרה לצלם את הילדים, שהילדים משחקים עם המים, אימא. הנה אימא, זה אימא, זה עידית, מתחבא שם. שלא יראו אותה. תסתכלי עידית, איזה פנים יפות. איזה דוגמנית, נשלח את התמונות להוליווד, שלח אותם. וואו, פרופיל. הולך לתמונה.
Just the leg, and everybody will say,
Is that Simi? Is that Danny? Danny, she gone? Oh, in Andrea, I'm a mime. As a yofi, Andrea, I'm a mime. The papi olech shama. Zoti Sara Hana. Hayom Sara Hana. כבר בת כמה? 20 יום. כן. הנה, הנה האחים של שרה חנה. היי, תחייך יפה. ושמחה. ואופה, אופה, איפה הוא? דני ברח לנו למטבח. אבל לא, לא עכשיו, רגע.
הנה הפיוטי פאי שלנו.
רגע, איפה היא שרה?
סייסי. הנה. My cutie pie, come here, look. Look.
דני היום, וכמה עוד מה דני יהיה בן חמש? זה דוד.
יאי, פור מי, יאי.
זה מתחייך יפה.
והנה
זאת היא שרה.
אוי, זה לא הייתה.
Birthday to you. Happy birthday. אצלה בבית, צעקנו לה, שרה, שרה. הנה, דני, עכשיו מוצא שבת, והתאריך היום הוא ה-16 לנובמבר 1991, ט' בכסלו, תשנ"ב. וזה דני, ילד גדול. ומי יש לי את דני? אחותו, שרה. מתנדנדת לה שמה. הנה, בוא נראה את דני ליד שרה. זאת שרה. זאת היא בבי.
Yeah, say hello to Abba on the video. Yell, David.
Hi, David. Lo shomim.
David, he can't hear you. I'm holding the phone up to the video.
Tzak, David.
Yell. Okay, we'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Gabi, go get David.
What happened? Opa. Hine, achot.
I'm I'm not telling. This is the wrong time on this clock, Kissimmee.
Oh, זה דני, איזה יופי, דני, ילד טוב. כן. וזאת שרה? זאת אמא שלהם. תגידי שלום, בובי. שושנת הבוקר הצהריים.
Bye, Gabby. Take Danny. Look what Danny wants to tell you. Sing, Danny. Do something.
בבי, תשאירי לנו שיר, בבי. בבי, תשאיר לנו סולו.
בבי. Look what Danny's doing. Let's מה? Do it.
אוקיי, דני, תעשה, מותק, כן, מותק, דני, תעשה. מה את עושה, בבי? אוקיי. סימי, בואי נה.
I'm getting you, סימי. I'm taking off my glasses. Mercy, mommy will not help you, סימי. Mercy, mommy will not help you.
שריקה. שרינה. באנו אצלה בבית, צעקנו, שרה, שרה. יצאה האימא שלה, זרקה עלינו קליפות של גרעינים וגרעינים של זיתים. שרינה! יא שרה! יא סוררת! הנה זה דני. דני, תשאיר לנו שיר שלמדת בגן. אוקיי. זה היה דני. טאה. מה מותק, תעשי משהו, כן. איזה חיוכים, יאללה, תן לנו איזה חיוך אחד ככה. קדימה, שרה. שרה. היום זה מסיבה של סימי. סימי בן 8, היום ב-17 לנובמבר 1991. זה נועה. זה צח. יוסקי סלר, זה גם יום הולדת בעברית של בבי. הנה סימי. תאבי עוד פעם ושימי של הילד, גם לה יש יום הולדת היום.
גבוה. זה היה בול. Time for the camera.
No, thank you, everybody.
It's spinning all over. Who's that? No, don't spit. Yeah,
I don't want any cake. No, thank you.
Save it. Today, Yom
Chamishi,
16 January. Sarah, come here, Tamia. בת ארבע חודשים, הייתה לפני שלושה ימים.
אמא שלה אוכלת אותה? אה, היא פולטת.
שרה.
לפסטה.
Talk to me, what? Tell Saba and Safa. Say hi. Say hi, it's me. Right. Tell them. Say, Saba and Sata, it's me. Yeah. What? Tell them. Tell them. What?
Sara.
What? Cookie, smile for them.
Shehem Yerush is a bemet bat, both is the clue my hair. Ta-da! Ta-da!
בעוד 20 שנה היא תרצה לראות את הוידאו, היא תהרוג אותך. תגיד, אמא, איך את מרשה להם לראות אותי
ככה?
אבא מצלם ואת לא לובשת ברוד. No, 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 פוסיקן, don't cry, what?
סארה, אני צריך לעצור את המצלמה, סארה, מה קורה? אמא הרביצה לה.
Sarah.
Bitzele. Bitzele. Bitzele.
הקולות של השטיח שאתם שומעים זה אמא של הילדה פה, אותה קולות של שטיח.
פצלה, שלום, 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 קם מאמא, קם שם. פצלה! 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 וואי, פצלה, קקי, קקי, tell him. Say, I'm a good girl. I'm a good girl.
Tell David to bring her red rings. תגיד להם שקר היום, את לובשת שני פיג'מה.
היום?
תגיד להם כמה מעלות היום מתחת.
היום אני חושב שזה 20 מעלות מתחת לאפס.
לא, לא, שזה לא יפריע לך. לא, 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 לא,
לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא, לא,
הרומנטיק
רד ווינג שלה. מה הוא עושה לך? מאפנט אותך, דיוויד?
זה
האופישל רומנטיק רד ווינגס. כמו בבלייזינג טאנלס. רד רוז! How romantic! Maybe I should clip it to something more comfortable to take. It's so delicious. And you're cute, too.
Boom.
Yes, here I got them.
Boom.
Sandwich, hold it. Sandwich, drop.
Tell her to bring up the brothers.
Here's your
woman. Sarika.
I'm going to take a look at her and I'm going to take a look at her.
Oh, my God. I've got to spike her hair.
Do it.
You're dropping your romantic
red
wings.
תעשי
לפן. romantic red wings.
שרה, תגידי לסבא וסבתא שלום. שרה. דיוויד, אתה מסתיר לי. אני לא רואה את שרה, אני רק רואה את ה...
romantic
red wings שלך.
זה romantic red wings.
דיוויד, תחזיק אותה.
David is laughing at her, and David is loving it. She's so cute.
Hey, בעדינות, מה זה?
She's so cute. And she's so
cute. Make her cry.
Bye, Mom. נתראות, everybody.
אנחנו ממשיכים, שרה הלכה לנוח קצת, עכשיו היא קמה. כן, מה? שרה? מה את אומרת לסבא וסבתא? את אומרת להם שלום? תגידי שלום לסבא וסבתא. נו? שרה, תגידי משהו, יאללה. אופ. איפה שרה? הנה שרה. אמא של שרה עכשיו הלכה לאמבטיה. האחים שלה כבר הלכו לישון. או שהם עובדים עליי, אני יודע. מה העניינים? שרה מתכוננת לנסוע לפלורידה. הם נוסעים ביום חמישי ויחזרו במוצאי שבת. הבנות, אנחנו עושים הפרדה במשפחת שבתאי בין הגברים לנשים. הגברים נוסעים לישראל והנשים לפלורידה. מה, תגידי. היי. Sarah?
Hi.
Sarika. Sarika. תשאירי לנו איזה שיר ביידיש אולי, שרה? טוב. את ממש בדרנית, אני רואה. חבר'ה מסתכלים עלייך ו... מה זה? אני ברצפה נפלתי וכיסא... אוקיי, להתראות. תגידי להם ביי, שרה. תגידי ביי. ביי, להתראות.
Christian Smith in this first half, and Tate George, his senior leadership has certainly come through for the Huskies.
That was a two-point goal as he was just inside the arc.
It's a big one, too, because it's a four-point game. This makes it six with a chance to go to seven. The arm contact and nothing but net for Tate.
I want to remind you that at halftime, we're going to take a look at the 1990 Big East Conference Plymouth All-Rookie Team. And you'll be seeing two of the young men we've seen out here in the first half of this game, Gary DeHare and Doug Hennefeld. That'll be at halftime. George makes it a three-point play.
Those two guys are a couple of the headliners on the All-Big East freshman team. Both of these guys, Hennefeld and DeHare, have had great seasons.
13 points now for Tate George, the lead all scorers here in the first half.
Cerulic is fouling Michael Cooper up top, just leaning on him.
This is Franz Volsky, gets it cross-court, DeHare.
Connecticut in the 1-3-1 trap themselves this time.
Steal down low by Burrell. The ball is slapped out of bounds. It'll be Seton Hall possession.
Connecticut just with a lot of different looks, mostly pressure traps. And Jim Calhoun always has his team with the hands up in the pressure situation.
Now Lokar is into the game for Seton Hall, and we told you he's a three-point specialist. He's really quite a bombardier from out there. 17 of 34.
It'll be a five. Season.
Stolen by Georgie, by Chris Smith. UConn with a seven-point lead. Burrell misses the stuff, hits the deck hard. And he'll be going to the free throw line. Boy, I tell you what, did he get ran.
Wow, another big fast break opportunity for the Huskies. Chris Smith draws him. Darryl Crist able to get over there. And Scott Burrell, fortunate that he was able to get his feet back down as he tumbles hard. He can get up.
He'll be at the line to shoot. Two free throws for the University of Connecticut. A moment ago, they were up by only four. Now they're up by seven, and with 53.2 seconds remaining in the first half, they've got a chance to go up by nine if Burrell gets both of them. That was their biggest lead of the first half, by the way. It's been nine. For UConn, Cerulic goes out. Rod Sellers is back in. Here you see the story with UConn. 35 steals in the two games.
That's been incredible, and that's what they've done in the first half, even though they haven't really shot it. As we said, that would make it easier for them. But the key has been the free throw shooting for UConn.
Ball to the floor, possession arrow, UConn. Connecticut now 14 of 17 at the foul line here in the first half. 8-point lead, 49.6 seconds remaining in the half. John Gwynn comes in for UConn, replacing Lyman DePreece. And Tate George will put it in play for the Huskies. George, big point guard, 6'5", getting it outside to Burrell.
Yeah, the thing is he wants the ball, too. He's been in this situation before. He just goes and gets it and takes charge the way you have to. Spread offense now for Connecticut.
Well, they can run it down to about 4 seconds in the first half because they've got 30 seconds on the shot clock and 34 left in the half as the clock is running.
So important to execute in these situations. Don't turn it over. Be good with the ball. Jim Calhoun's got a three-guard lineup out there as you see the game clock in the lower right-hand corner.
Now, Connecticut will have to shoot it before it gets to 4 seconds. There's your time remaining in the first half. George, Chris Smith, he'll take the shot. And
oh, tough one.
Shot. 10 seconds to go in the half. It is UConn by 10, their biggest lead of the first half. They're on a 6-0 run.
Got to get rid of it.
Cooper will fire it up and doesn't get it. And UConn is up by 10 at halftime at Madison Square Garden. Well, UConn have pushed it up to as many as 9. It got back to 4. Now they're back up by 10. That's the end of the first half. Madison Square Garden, our score, Connecticut leading 36-26. We'll be back after these local messages.
There's a new kind of money in circulation. Hungry money. Hungry money doesn't just lie there. It checks out all the options and heads straight for the bank that's as hungry as you are. Mid-Atlantic.
Confirming we've credited interest to all your accounts.
Investing or borrowing, trust accounts, CDs, it's all here at Mid-Atlantic, where the hungry money goes. All right, pal, let's go to work.
At 1,184,880 miles, a Mercedes-Benz 180D is in the Guinness Book of World Records as the world's most durable car. Just how far can a Mercedes actually go? Frankly, nobody knows.
Midas has been in the muffler business for 34 years. So when the other guys say they're just like us, we understand. What else can they say? Can they say they've installed over 100 million mufflers, both domestic and foreign? Can they say that they engineer and build their own mufflers for quality? Can they say that their guarantee is good in over 1,700 Midas shops? But we can say that. That's why we can say this. Nobody beats Midas. Nobody.
Heineken, Amstel Light.
This
so
is
much
it.
Better than other
it's a
light
great
beers.
Imported beer. I
a mean, delicious European
taste. Heineken and Amstel Light, America's number one selling imported and imported light beers.
In my opinion, me, Amstel Heineken Light is the best beer there is. I could go.
We're looking for a few good men with a medal to be Marines.
Everybody, this is Bob Page back at the MSG Sports Desk with our first report of the afternoon. Rival press briefings highlight the baseball impasse today. The players will hold a news conference momentarily to respond to the one the owners held at noon today. The owners try to explain their position by saying that their latest contract proposal would raise second-year players an average of $60,000 in salary a season. As you know, the eligibility of second-year players for arbitration has been a sticking point so far in the negotiations. As the Big East tourney continues here at the Garden, Syracuse and Pitt will match up at 7 o'clock tonight with St. John's versus Villanova to follow. Up next, of course, it's Georgetown against Providence, with John Thompson, at least, not taking the Friars lightly.
Very experienced team. Those kids have been in it. You know, he's got some kids that have been in it and probably a little wounded right now, probably feel that they'd like to do a lot better than they have done, and therefore they're a dangerous team because of it. You know, they've got pride. It's a good ball club.
Among many other college tournaments getting underway across the country this afternoon, the ACC tourney at Charlotte, which finds Clemson leading Wake Forest at halftime, 44-33. Now, last night saw what they're calling the biggest upset in WAC tourney history. Utah versus BYU in overtime. Off the missed free throw, Tommy Connor brings it up, drills a three-pointer with 7 seconds left that gives his team a 62-61 lead. Brigham Young's Andy Toulson shot misses at the buzzer. Utah prevails, the first time a seventh seed has ever knocked off a team seeded second in the postseason affair. Also last night, Temple won the Atlantic 10 tourney with a 53-51 victory over UMass in the finals. More coming up in just 30 seconds.
Hey, I'm a businessman. I want to fly in business class. Who wouldn't want to fly in business class? So why does it seem like there's never a business class flight when I want one? Answer that one, will you?
TWA has nearly three times as many domestic flights with business class as all other airlines combined.
Amazing. It's like they read my mind.
Today's TWA. Find out how good we really are.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there is never a dull moment in the wacky world of professional boxing, is there? An incident last night, however, may have taken the proverbial cake. At Atlantic City, Bazooka Limon, wearing green trunks, decides to take, shall we say, a novel approach to his bout with a guy named Sharn Bob Mitchell. If you can't stop a guy with your fists, you have to be a little resourceful and come up with other ways to distract him. Ron Hextall is out again. Hextall suffered a pulled left hamstring in last night's 7-5 loss to the Rangers at the Spectrum in Philly. It happened on a goal by Normand Rochefort, on which Hextall went down doing the splits. Now, this is not the same hamstring that has kept Hextall out much of the season to date. With his new injury, he will be lost to the troubled Flyers indefinitely. And after withdrawing from the U.S. Davis Cup tennis team on Wednesday, Andre Agassi has now lashed out at U.S. team captain Tom Gorman, and I quote, "He's a chameleon. He is negligent and gutless. It's tough. You have a follower in a leader's position, and the country has to pay for it," end quote. Although Gorman wouldn't respond to Agassi's charges, he may not be too upset about leaving him off the team. After all, Agassi lost two matches last summer in U.S.'s defeat at the hands of West Germany. Aaron Krickstein will take Agassi's place. Also last night in tennis, if you missed it, at the Virginia Slims tourney down in Boca Raton, Pam Shriver broke her toe. She'll be out of action the next 3 to 6 weeks. How did she do it? Out of frustration, kicking a chair after a straight sets loss. Meanwhile, 13-year-old Jennifer Capriati, the tennis sensation making her pro debut, won again yesterday. She now has advanced to the quarterfinals of that tourney. And we'll return to our East matchup after again this time out.
New York's the greatest city where people work hard. It's got everything all by far. The buildings, the pace, the energy too. There ain't nothing in the city that you can't do. But when it comes to chilling and found the ball, New Yorkers take the Knicks the biggest thrill of all. Pump it up for the jamming, cause you got to see the Knicks are only found on MSG. Huh. The Knicks are home to take on the New Jersey Nets Saturday night at 8 here on MSG Network.
It's a feline fancier's dream. More than 1,000 of the world's most beautiful champion cats all gathered in one place, from the most common to the most exotic. Don't miss MSG Network's exclusive coverage as Sheba presents the 1990 International Cat Show from the Garden, Sunday afternoon at 2, here on MSG Network.
The New York Yankees are back on MSG Network. It's an exciting new season as MSG's coverage features a great new team. Wayne Statz will handle the play-by-play. Tony Kubek will provide the analysis, and Al Troutwig will host the pre- and post-game shows. MSG's 78-game schedule begins with 3 spring training games, Montreal on the 24th and 28th, and Baltimore on the 29th. Don't miss the 1990 Yankees here on MSG Network.
Over 50 years of college basketball tradition, the National Invitation Tournament at Madison Square Garden has featured the great teams, the great players, and the great plays. Be a part of the continuing NIT spirit. Don't miss the excitement of the 53rd National Invitation Tournament, a college basketball classic, March 26th and 28th. Tickets on sale now at the Garden box office and all Ticketmaster outlets. To charge, call 212-307-7171. Madison Square Garden, where else would the greatest college basketball be?
It's furious. Rangers hockey. It's the fastest game in town.
Rangers Canucks. Pizza Hut poster night, Sunday, March 18th, 7:30.
To the Big East tournament with UConn leading it by 10, 36-26. They did that off of a 6-0 run over the final 2.5 minutes of the half. Our first half statistics, Seton Hall actually outshooting UConn in terms of percentage, but both clubs not shooting it well in the first half. Big edge to Ronnie Perry for UConn at the free throw line.
Yeah, they've done a good job there. They haven't all year long, really. They've been in the mid-60s shooting free throws today. They have made the most of their opportunities, and they have 7 more
field goal attempts than Seton Hall in the first half.
Here's the big story of the first half. UConn with 10 steals. They came in averaging 12, and they've gotten 10 of them.
That's been the big story. It's been UConn's defense and their ability when they have stolen the basketball to go down and score with it, as the points off turnovers have also been a big stat in this first half. They've been able to get it done. And there it is, 16-4 in that category. Seton Hall has just been tentative, trying to break the pressure.
Seton Hall had moved to within 4 points at 30-26 with about 2.5 minutes left in the first half as Terry DeHare started to get hot. But then the 14-5 turnover situation, 16-4 actually now, points off turnovers. 14 turnovers for Seton Hall, 5 for Connecticut in the first half. Let's take a look at some of the highlights of the first half. An inbounds pass from Seton Hall stolen here by UConn.
Well, one of the steals that they had, one of the 10 in the first half, and in a very unselfish job by Gwynn to get it over to Tate George so that he can dunk the ball, as Tate George had a very effective first half for Connecticut. But offense off of defense and contributions from a lot of people. Off the bench, Lyman DePriest with a great up fake really gets Avent out of the picture. And this is where DePriest likes it, in traffic where he can scrap, able to get the ball to go down.
On the other end of the floor, Seton Hall had one of its better offensive situations right here when Avent got it down in low to Franz Bolsey.
And the key is Cooper getting the ball right in the middle, and that's where you split the defense, get it away from the sidelines and the traps, and you can go in and score. Seton Hall must do more of that in the second half.
Big edge for the University of Connecticut backcourt, the senior Tate George with the 13 points in the first half, and Chris Smith, the sophomore from Bridgeport, Connecticut, with 14 points in the first half. Let's take a look at all of the individual scoring in the first half of the ball game. First of all, for Seton Hall, DeHare started to get hot. He's got himself 8 points, but Avent was Anthony Avent, their center, was kept for the collar in the first half, did not score. Connecticut, that backcourt's just doing a marvelous job.
That's where it came from. They just took charge in the first half, and John Gwynn with a good jump shot. They're banging inside, but it's been a backcourt duel. UConn with the big edge so far.
UConn, as we told you, finished the first half with a 6-0 run over the final two and a half minutes to go up by 10 at the half. How can Seton Hall chop into this thing in the second half, Ronnie, and how can they prevent the steals? That's killing them.
They've got to do a better job against pressure, get the ball more to the middle to Michael Cooper and the big people, and get it low to the big people, and of course, get DeHare hot from the outside.
UConn, a conference coach. With defense, they're doing it that way here. Back with the second half in a moment.
This week on Sports Forum, the story of Mercury Morris. Two Super Bowl championships with the Miami Dolphins, 3.5 years in prison, perhaps put there unjustly. And today he preaches the story of a life gone better.
Well, I've learned some valuable lessons in life, and one of them is that you don't drown by jumping in the water, you drown by staying in it.
Mercury Morris, this week on Sports Forum.
When you want the action and the stories in the world of sports, and all of it right up to the minute, the place to turn is MSG Sports Desk, every night throughout the night on MSG Network.
And win with the Mets. Each time you use your Mets MasterCard from Manufacturers Hanover Trust, you get another entry to the Mets MasterCard sweepstakes. And each month, there's a powerful lineup of great that you can win. So if you've got the card, use it. If you don't, apply now. Hey, who knows more about winning with the Mets than me? The Mets MasterCard from Manufacturers Hanover. To apply, call 1-800-MHT-METS anytime.
Uh-oh, what's wrong? There's just 1 minute made left.
I'll play you for it.
Man, I got thirsty just watching you guys.
Minute Maid Orange, the orange orange.
You could win a shot at Isaiah Thomas, Patrick Ewing, and me. 3-on-3. Anywhere you buy Minute Maid Orange. Got it?
In a world of distractions and unexpected turns, a car should be like a friend you don't have to talk to.
The Mazda 626 is actually engineered to feel just that way, resulting in an uncanny ability to make you feel in control. At the same time, it makes you feel relaxed. The 626 from Mazda.
How do you pick a winner?
I sit down with my Harry and his clicker. Six numbers, 3 seconds flat. Thank you, dear.
The highest reading of the day. That's my method.
A six-digit total, everything on sale. It's got to be a lucky number.
4, 10.
Every Monday, somebody's six lucky numbers could win at least $100,000 in cash in New York Cash 40.
9.
New York Cash 40. Every day's a play day.
Big East Basketball is brought to you by your local Chrysler, Plymouth, and Dodge dealers, by John Hancock Financial Services, real life, real answers, and by Mercedes-Benz, engineered like no other car in the world.
Toes and Ronnie Perry. The UConn Huskies 36-26 over the Pirates of Seton Hall at halftime. A 6-0 burst over the final couple of minutes of the first half, giving the Huskies the lead and making that Husky a happy one here in the first half of play anyway. UConn will start the second half. Smith, George, Burrell, Hennefeld, and Sellers. It is not a big club. Sellers the biggest guy at 6'9", then Hennefeld at 6'7". Burrell and George at 6'5", and Smith at 6'3". But they are, or 6'2", actually. They're very, very quick and tenacious on defense, Ronnie. They never stop coming at you defensively.
That's right. They've got a lot of good size, similar type athletes, Gil, and they've always got their hands up. And I think it makes the passing lanes very difficult for people. They tend to have to lob the ball instead of being real aggressive with bounce passes that lead to baskets.
Oliver Taylor for Seton Hall to start the second half. DeHare guns a three, doesn't get it. Rebound into the hands of Scott Burrell. This is Chris Smith ahead to take George, the point guard for UConn. Burrell on a high post. Now Hennefeld. George posting up himself. Does not get it, but gets a foul. Seton Hall committing its first foul of the second half. And this one is on Terry DeHare. It will put Tate George at the free throw line.
Where Tate George uses his size advantage. He can go in and post up against people that are defending against him. Very important for Seton Hall in the second half early to get a couple of shots to go down. George having a very good afternoon for himself and cut this 10-point lead down instead of letting UConn build on it.
13 first half points for Tate George. He averaged 11 in the Big East season. Now 14 for the senior guard from Newark, New Jersey, as his head coach Jim Calhoun looks on. His fourth year at UConn. Took them from seventh last year to first place this year. To the penthouse in
That's
one
a,
season.
A nice trip to take.
Sure is. The two free throws for Tate George, and now UConn has its biggest lead of the game, 12 points. This is the point in time where Seton Hall had better be very careful, but UConn has the ability to rip off a lot of points off of their defense.
And it's the 2-2-1 press that they stay with. It's their mainstay defensively, and they continue to work at it.
Aven on the lob pass from Michael Cooper. Good little unbank, and he lays it in.
Well, P.J. Carlissimo clearly talked at halftime to his team about getting the ball inside. That's Aven's first bucket of the game, and you can see Cooper was really looking inside.
They go down low to Sellers. The jump ball situation is called. The possession arrow is pointing to, was pointing to UConn. It has to be going the other, was pointing to Seton Hall. And now the possession is Connecticut's. Our officials today, Jim Burr, Larry Lembo, and Bob Donato.
That's Jimmy Burr right there.
Tate George try to inbound. The UConn lead is 10. Hennefeld in the first half had just 2 points. But this man, Tate George, certainly took up the scoring slack that Hennefeld was unable to contribute.
Chris Smith poured in the points, so it was a lot of backcourt scoring out of UConn. Now they're mixing it up.
Scott Burrell. Little post-up move of his own, and again, it's the Huskies by 12. Taylor gets it on the high post to Cooper. He's got three men with him. Aven is trapped and stolen by Burrell. The quick hands of the UConn defense in the story of the game, the steal.
That's still effective with the press, even when you get it underneath the opponent's basket.
Sellers wanted to post up. Aven had blocked his way. Now Burrell from the high post, trying to make the move. Chris Smith dumps it off through the hands of Sellers. Hennefeld.
Nice look.
Nice pass. Slapped away, but Tate George has it on the other end for the Huskies. Still 20 seconds to go on the 45-second shot clock.
This gives you an indication of how long 45 seconds really is.
Beautiful move by George. Couldn't follow it up with the basket. Ball out of bounds off UConn. It'll be Seton Hall bringing it down. Michael Cooper will put it in play. B.J. Carlissimo trying to figure out a way to prevent his club from having the ball stolen so often. There were now 11 steals in the game for UConn.
Got to be aggressive with the ball. You can't be tentative. Get the ball to DeHair and go right at things offensively.
Taylor, rainbow from the corner. Tate George comes out of there. Two on two. George, beautiful pass to the trailer. Sellers fouled by Anthony Avent. What a great job by Tate George. Just the feel that that trailer was there.
Yeah, this is just a nice job. You wonder, how does he know? But he just peeked before this. Goes with the over-the-shoulder job. And had Avent not been in the flow that time, that would have been a big jam by Sellers.
Fourth personal foul on Anthony Avent. Two shots. 6'9", 225-pound junior. This is Rod Sellers to shoot two shots for UConn.
Now, in the NCAA tournament, Gil, this is where the coaches will have to make a strategic adjustment and get players out when they've got four. But in Big East player course this year, with the six fouls, you can leave a player in there, particularly now where Seton Hall has to have everybody out there.
The two free throws for Rod Sellers. It is now a 14-point lead for Connecticut, their biggest lead of the game. And if Seton Hall is going to make a serious run here in the second half of the ball game, they're going to have to start it real soon. A foul as Hennefeld came up with another steal.
I think it was Avent.
Seton Hall is going to call for a timeout. Anthony Avent has just picked up his fifth personal foul. And right now, the Pirates are in serious trouble. 17-17 to go in the game. UConn by 14.
When you were 21,
yeah,
we drank a toast to it.
Yeah,
we can't do that. When you were 30,
yeah,
you could boast of it.
Yeah.
Now you're 40. Look at there. See? So make the most of it. Well, isn't that clever?
Yeah.
During the week, nobody tells it like the Daily News. Hard driving, fast-paced, provocative, up-to-date, the news you need. But Sunday, it's City Lights, TV Week, two magazines, comics and coupons, gossip and sports. What you need, what you want, the Daily News.
Hey, party-timers! I got some special birthday party tips for you from Extra Gold Draft.
First, don't forget the extra gold. More beer taste. Extra smooth. Ask for an extra.
Another tip. When you make a wish... Make it a wish, yes. Yes. No.
When you want more beer, ask for an extra.
Come here. Whoa!
The Plymouth player of the game to be selected at the conclusion of this game, as during every game televised for the Big East Conference Television Network, as part of the Chrysler Corporation sponsorship of Big East basketball. This quarterfinal round opening game, 42-28. UConn on top. They've outscored Seton Hall 14-4 over the last 6 minutes of play. That includes the last couple of minutes of the first half. George getting it low to Smith, a reach-in foul, and Darryl Crist as Seton Hall has made some changes. They've got Lokar and Crist in the backcourt now, with Cooper, Volsey, and Winchester up front.
Well, P.J. Carlissimo has been trying every combination in the backcourt to see what might click in this game.
Smith dumping it off inside. We've got a foul before the pass.
Crist again.
Yes, it is, and that will be the fifth team foul on Seton Hall. The third on Darryl Criss, the fifth on Seton Hall in the second half. UConn has yet to commit a foul in the second half.
Well, and the free throws were big for UConn in the first half, so we'll see if that continues.
Alley-oop, and not quite high enough.
Nice block.
Yes, sir. Darryl Criss pushing it back for Seton Hall. They trail by 14 points.
They really need to generate, as you said. They've got to get a couple of positive things going offensively. Not taking good care of it.
Block there. Ball re-stolen by Marco Locar. Goes to the deck for it. Right into the hands of George.
Oh, good look.
Line pass to Smith. Blocked by Volsi. And picked off by Michael Cooper. Play getting a little ragged right now.
Now, that was quite an exchange where no one was able to get the job done with the ball. Chris Smith. Gets a little sloppy at times, but Connecticut likes to create some havoc when they're playing against the opposition. They're doing that right now to Seton Hall. This is a great look by Tate George. Lost a couple of assists here in the first half as Chris Smith can't get it to go down. Cooper with the strong board.
16 minutes, 15 seconds remaining in the basketball game.
Connecticut now back to the man-to-man defense. They've mixed that up with some zone pressure.
George, Darryl Criss was looking inside, trying to get it to Volsi, but good defense. Now he gets it. And a big time block by Rod Sellers.
He got up that time, didn't he?
Didn't he? He was head and shoulders above everybody.
Got a new fitted brace on his left knee. Seems to be moving very well, and with the good dish here by Criss, Volsi just can't get it up over Sellers. Only thing Sellers didn't do was keep it in play.
Volsi with a jumper from the right and the miss, and the Tate George rebound. Ahead to Smith. Too far ahead. Keeps it in play. And into the hands of Gordon Winchester of Seton Hall.
Again, it looked like Criss Smith wanted to go up before he gathered the ball in.
Marco Locar has hit one shot in the game, and that was a three-pointer. He is fouled. The reach in on Tate George. Second personal on George. Second team foul on UConn in the second half. Possession foul. John Gwynn will be coming in for the University of Connecticut. He replaces Criss Smith. Gwynn, the instant offense guy, junior from Hillcrest Hills, Hillcrest Heights in Maryland.
To Matha High School. Great high school program. First player from that high school program to play in the Big East. And he has fit his role very nicely, as have a lot of people for UConn this year.
Cooper dumping it off to Winchester. The steal right out of his hands by Hennefeld. Ahead to Tate George.
Like Hennefeld, he's been the steal master all year long. He's open.
Traveling. Tate George moving both of his feet as he was getting that pass away to Hennefeld. Now UConn turns it over, and Seton Hall will put it in play. The Hall scored just 2 points in the first 4 minutes and 40 seconds of this second half.
Obviously not getting the kind of start we talked about for the second half, but Connecticut right now getting out of what they want to do offensively.
Michael Cooper, an offensive foul, has put Seton Hall at the limit of 16 fouls. So the next one they commit will put Connecticut on the free throw line, and that's where UConn made some hay in the first half.
As Seton Hall just unable to capitalize when they get their opportunities.
Seton Hall has not scored in the last 4 minutes. Burrell outside. We'll see the rebound of the missed shot. Darryl Criss coming back for Seton Hall. They're approaching 5 minutes without a point here in this second half of play. They scored early. There's Locar for three. No. Rebound the corner. Tate George. NFL. George, UConn up by 14. The shot doesn't go for George, but he was fouled by Marco Locar. And Tate George will go to the line to shoot two for his University of Connecticut Huskies.
Well, Tate George has just really taken charge with the ball in this game. In a lot of games, he just runs the floor, gets it to people. In this one, he's shooting the ball over people. He's very offensive-minded, and he's got 3 or 4 inches over Locar.
George is the leading scorer in the ball game with 15 points, 5 out of 7 on the floor. He also has 6 steals.
How about getting involved out there, Tate?
I think I recall him getting a rebound or two as well. One more free throw for Tate George. Senior out there with the win in the backcourt right now. Burrell, Hennefeld, and Sellers, the front court. George gets his 16th point of the game and a 15-point lead for UConn.
Well, UConn's done what they've had to here, setting the tempo in this second half. And Seton Hall right now threaten to be put out of this game if they can't get a couple of things to go down offensively.
Lopar loses the handle on it. Back come Connecticut's Huskies. Burrell losing it. George on the block. Great play by Volsey.
And Winchester get in there.
Cooper to the basket, strong for two.
Now that could be a turning point kind of play for the Hall to keep themselves alive in this one.
The basket coming off of the big defensive play breaks a 5.5 minute Seton Hall scoring drive. 43-30, UConn. Win. Looking for daylight, can't find it. Doesn't need a lot of daylight, I'll tell you that.
He'll launch it. He has just a crack out there. The Hall staying mainly with the man defense, and they've got to bear down now. Huskies in complete control.
Wynn, Tate George, 15 on the shot clock for Connecticut.
Marcel has really wanted that ball.
Wynn, no, rebound, Winchester.
Seton Hall doing a pretty good job now getting the defensive rebounds.
Darryl Criss now finds Volsey. Winchester took steps. And they turn it over again. That's been Seton Hall's biggest bugaboo all year long, turning the ball over. And Connecticut has forced them into turnovers galore here in this one. In the first half, 14 Seton Hall turnovers.
That's what UConn has done all year long, and they've already got Seton Hall matching the turnover numbers that opponents have averaged against them this year with all kinds of time left to play in this game.
NFL goes out. Cyrulik is in for UConn.
I really think for Seton Hall to make the run, they're going to have Oliver Taylor and DeHaer out on the floor.
A three-pointer by John Gwynn.
When he does best, fills it up with the jumper.
UConn by 16, their biggest lead.
You track points per minute played. You've got to have Gwynn right up near the top. 17 minutes a game, and he averages better than 10 a game.
Seton Hall has scored just 4 points here in the second half. As UConn has hit them with a blistering pace. Prince misses. Cooper had a hand on it, could not control it. It's out of bounds off Connecticut. It'll be Seton Hall ball. It was 36-26 at the half. A 10-4 start to the second half for UConn. Christ is out. Oliver Taylor back in for Seton Hall. Lokar on the inbounds to Cooper. Lokar again gets it back. Out there.
Well, with the zone now, Lokar can hit the jump shot, and he's got great range. UConn has to keep an awareness of him out there.
Volsey, Taylor, and now Lokar. Oliver Taylor for three, gets the three.
That's not easy, Gil. He's been on the bench now for several minutes, comes right out shooting.
Coming into this game, Taylor had hit 14 three-pointers over the course of the entire season. That cuts the UConn lead to 13, but Connecticut is playing like a team in control, Ronnie Perry.
Yeah, they are. They're working the clock. If they don't have the break, they're taking some time off it. And as always, they're keeping the defensive pressure on. The key for them is to score so they can set up that three-quarter court press.
There's Tate George, who's having a heck of a ball game.
Got the feel, and again, look at Jim Calhoun changing defenses, and when you score, you really can dictate the tempo.
18 points in the game for Tate George. 15-point lead for the Huskies. This is their second biggest lead. They led a moment ago by, they were led by 16 a moment ago. Now they're up by 15. Taylor getting on the high post to Winchester. Tries to make his move on Murray Williams, and a foul is called on Williams. That will be just the third team foul, however, on Connecticut.
For Seton Hall right now against Jim Calhoun's press, what P.J. Colissimo will need is more penetration to get it to the big people to make a run.
11:40 to go in the basketball game. UConn up by 15 to the Big East quarterfinals after these local messages.
Now Patrick moving out. Lee Percussio onside. He moves in and shoots. He scores!
As the NHL's regular season winds down, the Rangers are in the middle of a Patrick Division scramble. Now the stakes are high. Heck, all playoff spots are up for grabs. The race will be tied all the way, and the Rangers are looking to new faces and tough veterans for a big postseason run. The Rangers travel to Minnesota to battle the tough North Stars. Saturday afternoon at 2:30 here on MSG Network. It's
college basketball tournament time, and the game rockets to new heights whenever March rolls around. See the nation's finest teams and premier players battle it out for tournament seedings and postseason honors. Catch the exciting Pac-10 Conference Finals Sunday afternoon at 4, live here on MSG Network. Over 50 years of college basketball tradition, the National Invitation Tournament at Madison Square Garden has featured the great teams, the great players, and the great plays. Be a part of the continuing NIT spirit. Don't miss the excitement of the 53rd National Invitation Tournament, a college basketball classic, March 26th and 28th. Tickets on sale now at the Garden box office and all Ticketmaster outlets. To charge, call 212-307-7171. Madison Square Garden, where else would the greatest college basketball be?
Madison Square Garden, Gil Santos and Ronnie Perry. UConn has built its lead up to 15. They were up 10 at the half. Seton Hall has had a tough time in Big East tournaments over the years. You can see they've lost the first game 6 out of 10 times. 4 and 10 in the tournament overall. Comes inbounds to Michael Cooper. Cooper being pressured. Takes it low. Dump pass off to Volsey, but steps are called. And Seton Hall will turn it over. Georgetown, Tate George is 18 points, leading the UConn Huskies. There is a great turnaround season for them. Big East co-champions for the first time, never finished higher than fourth, and of course they're in the AP top 10.
A lot of firsts for the Huskies this year as they've put it all together.
Cerulean, 7'1". Now Williams. This is John Gwynn. Gwynn takes
oh,
it
nice
to the
move.
Basket strong.
What Gwynn does, he gets people playing him out tight. And he'll get it to the goal on occasion. And here's Connecticut's 2-2-1 press. They'll try to trap just over midcourt.
17-point lead for the Huskies. This is their biggest of the game. Cooper, foul line jumper short. Picked off and a foul.
Walking.
Traveling. Lyman DePriest was backing up, being bumped around.
Yeah, it might have been a little contact there, although Lyman DePriest was a great tight end coming out of high school, so he's used to that kind of bumping action. Seton Hall right now seems to be completely out of sync offensively as Connecticut's man-to-man defense and zone pressure is posing all kinds of problems. Oh, nice move, though, by Taylor.
Taylor has really been the only offense in the second half for Seton Hall. He has 5 points in the second half, and Seton Hall has scored just 9 in the second half. There's a reach-in foul on Cooper that will put Lyman DePriest at the free throw line. St. George's 18 points, by the way, in this game so far, his season high, and he's threatening his own career high, which was 24.
It's a nice time if you're Tate George to put that together. Big East tournament time.
George also with 6 steals. There's Tate George. He's been the key man in this Connecticut 15-point lead at this point in time. 10:27 to play in the basketball game. Lyman DePriest, not a good free throw shooter in the regular season in the Big East, at only 45%. Rebound tip deep. Everything's going UConn's way right now, Ronnie.
That's right. When you've got the momentum in your favor, you tend to get the good bounces.
Williams, now DePriest for UConn. John Gwynn, that's how quickly he gets the shot off. Won't drop for him. Tip no. Rebound Winchester. Oliver Taylor has been the only really good offense in the second half for Seton Hall. Dickinson getting it low. Franz Volsey posts up for the hoop, count the basket, and he's fouled.
Well, a rare occasion where Seton Hall was able to aggressively get the ball down low to either Volsey, Avon, of course, out of the game right now with 5 fouls.
It's a good pass here from the freshman 7-footer, Jim Dickinson.
Yeah, see, Dickinson can see over the defense there, and he just makes a good pass. Cerulek has got excellent position, but just leans a bit with the body. His arms were straight up. And Connecticut continues its dominance from the foul line. That's turning out to be a major story in this one.
Now they've outscored them by 13 and had 19 more attempts. 50-37, UConn. Williams is fouled by Franz Volsey. And Murray Williams will step to the line. He's a junior from Torrington, Connecticut. Third foul on Franz Volsey.
Number 32, Tate George.
Tate George back in for UConn. He replaces John Gwynn.
Nice job by Gwynn. Gwynn comes off the bench to score points. Lyman DePriest comes off with some steady defense. Cerulla comes in, Gil, to back up at the center position, rebound, and try to get some offensive rebounds, and they all seem to be filling those roles nicely.
They have some very good bench players. They really do.
And here's another one, too. Murray Williams, who has started some games this year, didn't start today. Scott Burrell did, but Murray Williams is a steady player as well.
Rebound taken down by big Michael Cooper.
He is big.
He certainly is. Looks like a linebacker.
He's chiseled.
13-point lead for the Huskies. Taylor trying to drive on Smith is fouled, and that'll be the fifth team foul on Connecticut, the fourth personal on Chris Smith.
He's given it the pushed off signal. Won't get the call, though. Don't see too many of those reversed.
Nearly a five-second call on Seton Hall. Marco Lokar had to quickly turn and call a timeout. So with 9:45 left to play in the basketball game, the University of Connecticut Huskies are leading it by 13 points. We'll be back to Madison Square Garden after these words from our local stations.
I love what you do for me, Toyota. I love how you set me free, Toyota.
Toyota's new four-wheel drive, four-door, four-runner for 1990. Space, luxury, and V6 power. Where you go is your concern. Getting you back is ours.
I love what you do for me, Toyota.
Now it eats these things, all right? It opens its mouth, and then it goes.
Peter, no TV till you've had your breakfast.
Now it eats these things, all right?
Well, don't worry, Mr. Bowen, you're covered.
Thank you.
It's automatic when you use the American Express card.
Lost, stolen, or damaged, a way to protect the things you buy.
South Carolina.
After the long, cold winter, you need a place to unwind. There's never been a better time. The beaches are golden here, and the pleasures are yours to enjoy. Right now, South Carolina is all yours. Call 1-800-451-8188 now for your free vacation guide.
South Carolina.
There's your story. The University of Connecticut with a 13-point lead, 15-13. Seton Hall has turned it over 22 times. UConn, Tate George, the leading scorer with 18 points and 6 steals, one short of the tournament record. Inbounds, squeezing off the two is Gordon Winchester.
Another big story there was the 17 more free throw attempts by Connecticut. They've gotten the ball to the goal in this game. DePriese with an aggressive pick against Lokar.
It is 50-39. Seton Hall is within 11. This is the closest they've been since the opening moments of the second half. Smith, off balance shot, doesn't drop. Rebound, UConn, no. Slapped around, it'll be UConn ball.
DePriest in the right place at the right time, unable to cash in. And it looked like P.J. Colosimo talked about defensive intensity during that timeout, as Seton Hall looks a lot more aggressive than they have defensively in this game.
Murray Williams to inbounds for the Huskies. Way out, throws it into the backcourt to Tate George. The Hall on a 6-0 run to try to get back into this thing right now.
Well, they've got to do it now. There's still 9 minutes to go, and they're only down 11. Oh, good luck.
Beautiful. Beautiful. See? Tate George finds Rod Sellers. Drew the defense to him. Sellers all alone under the hoop.
He's doing it all in this game. Steals, assists, and points.
Well, he's a senior, and he is the captain. To the basket. Winchester short with it. Rebound Williams. Over the top foul, Winchester. Murray Williams to the other end to shoot 1-1 for the University of Connecticut. Winner of this game plays the winner of our next game here at Madison Square Garden. Providence and Georgetown. Those two clubs played a pair of incredible games during the regular season. Both of them, both clubs in both games went over 90 points.
Right, it was a one-point win for Georgetown at the Cap Center and a four-point win for Providence at the Civic Center in Providence.
Williams drilling the front end of the 1-1, so he will get one more.
What a job Jim Calhoun has done. Coach of the Year this year in the Big East. Took a team that many people thought would finish, well, they were picked eighth in the preseason Big East poll to tie for first. A team that has just come together. A lot of times you talk about chemistry, but that's a good word to use for UConn this year. Not a lot of marquee players, but a team that plays well together. Defense is always there.
Very good defensive team and a very unselfish team. And they're deep. They've got people on the bench that can play. Taylor pumps a three, drills a three. He's had a heck of a game. He's the only guy really having a good game. All alone is Hennepel. Home run pass to Nadav Hennepel. And it's back up to a 14-point spread for UConn. 56-42. Time remaining 8:15. There you see it.
Every time Seton Hall does something positive, UConn comes right back. Is Taylor again.
He feels it, doesn't get it this time. And the ball is ripped away by Rod Sellers, and we're going to get a foul. I believe that'll be number 5 on Fonz and Volsi. Number 4 on Volsi.
Been a frustrating day, though, for Fonz. Been able to get a couple of things going on inside. But again, we talked about the ability of Volsi and Avent to get it going together. And Avent with 5 fouls and just 2 points is on the bench. The hot hand has been Taylor. Can't get it to go. And there's a lot of people trying to claim territory to the ball. And finally, Rod Sellers says, it's mine. It's fouled on the play.
Sellers with a 1-and-1. Nothing but net on the first one. One more for Sellers.
His emergence this year in the middle has really helped UConn as well. We've talked about a lot of people. In the middle, though, he's been consistent with the rebounding and the points all year long.
From Florence, South Carolina. Doesn't get the second one. Murray Williams got into the way of it. The ball is tied up, and then we've got a reach-in foul
on Williams.
On UConn, on Williams. And that will be the 6th team foul on the University of Connecticut. So they are at the limit. Michael Cooper to inbounds for Seton Hall's Pirates. Here comes Oliver Taylor.
And DeHare is back out there now. He's the kid that better get himself back into the flow now. See if he can get a couple of threes going up there. That's the route that Seton Hall will have to go to down the stretch.
7:45 left to play in the ball game. Winchester getting it to Taylor. The baseline, the up fake, can't do anything. Throws it away right to Chris Smith. 3-on-3, Williams on the cut, rapidly to the hoop for a pair.
Nice fast break by the University of Connecticut. Smith over to Williams. They've got all cylinders going right now. Again, Keith Gill off of a steal. It's been the story.
Absolutely. UConn's quick hands and intelligence in getting into the passing lanes time and again have taken the ball away from Seton Hall. 12, 13, 14 times in steals. We'll get the exact number in a moment.
Over 20 turnovers for Seton Hall. Talked to Jim Calhoun before the game, and he said, we're going to play the pressure defense the whole game. We're going to play it for the rest of this season. It's what's got us here, and we are really effective at the end of games. Teams get tired against us.
DeHare can't get the ball to drop for him, but he was fouled by Rod Sellers. And Terry DeHare will go to the free throw line to shoot 2 for the Pirates, who are now down by 17. They had moved to within 11, but back came Connecticut with a 6-0 run. It's been a game of 6-0 runs for Connecticut. 6-0 to close out the first half, which I thought was a key, Ronnie, because if Seton Hall goes in at halftime down by just 4 of those points off turnovers, 26-6. With 2 minutes left in the first half, Seton Hall was trailing by 4. UConn hit him with a 6-0 blitz. That made it a 10-point deficit at halftime. You got to feel a lot better going into halftime down by 4 than down by 10. Then to start the second half, UConn another 6-0 run. And here again, now it's broken by DeHare's free throw. And UConn keeps putting the distance between themselves and Seton Hall.
Well, you make a good point, because I think 10 points is sort of a big psychological number at halftime. And if you can build on that coming out in the second half, that's what UConn has done. And Seton Hall just hasn't been able to effectively answer the challenge of handling the defensive pressure in this game.
Nadav Hennepel trying to shovel pass it off the dribble. The ball is out of bounds off Connecticut, and it'll be a Seton Hall ball.
This has been a game where Nadav Hennepel has been so critical in a lot of games for the Huskies. He has had a kind of a tough afternoon.
Yes,
he didn't shoot it well to start the game, but continues to do the little things that other people pick up the slack, which is a sign of a real good team.
There's a steal to Hennepel. 3-on-2. Pulls up.
Knock it down.
Doesn't get it. Gets another rebound off it. And got it.
Good play by Hennepel. It's the kind of kid he is. He'll keep doing the little things.
The thing about Hennepel, whether he's passing it or shooting it, going in for a rebound, economy of movement. He doesn't make a lot, take a lot of steps to get to where he wants to be. He's very quick in his movements.
He's got a good sense of where he wants to be, and he's always near the ball.
Taylor,
there he
blocked.
Is again.
That time, Hennepin got a block. You're right, he's always near the ball. Taylor in the paint, gets it to go.
Well, he's been the offensive story for the Pirates in the second half.
He's got 12 points overall, 10 in the second half. 10 of Seton Hall's 20 points. Sellers has it stripped. A foul, however, is going to be called on Oliver Taylor, and that is number 4 on Taylor.
Well, Seton Hall is really racking up the fouls now. Another area where Connecticut has been effective. Oliver Taylor pushes with his arms there. If he was over another half a step, he would have been in great position to take the charge.
5:41 left in this quarterfinal game. Game one of the day here at Madison Square Garden. After us, Georgetown and Providence College. And then tonight at 7, St. John's meets, Syracuse meets Pitt. And at 9:30, St. John's and Villanova. The missed free throws by Sellers, though it remains 61-46. 15-point advantage for UConn. They had that 15-point lead with 12 minutes left in this half. Now, with 5.5 minutes left, it's still a 12-point lead, or 15-point lead. Rebound Sellers, foul Seton Hall. And the Pirates right now, with only 5:22 to go, down by 15, appear to be playing their final game of the season.
Wow.
Connecticut has really dominated this second half.
They have, and B.J. Colosimo has tried different combinations. His team is frustrated right now, and when the team gets frustrated and the ball won't go down, you tend to see a lot of fouls, and they are mounting right now on the Pirates. Hooper just committing his fourth.
Sellers the 1-1. He's 4 of 8 at the line in the ball game so far. Gets the front one to drop, so he'll get another. Rod Sellers now with 7 points in the ball game. His season average is 9. Rebound Michael Cooper. 62-46. UConn. 5:18 to play. Cooper, DeHare. 3-point shot. No. Rebound Hennepin. Here comes UConn. 4-on-2. George. 20 points for Tate George.
Does a nice job there to avoid the offensive foul.
DeHare, other end. Ball is out of bounds.
That was a foul on Rod Sellers.
I was amazed the whistle didn't blow.
I think Bob Donato might have called it.
Okay. He did call it. We didn't hear the whistle.
Well, here's DeHare just looking at Sellers. He knew there would be contact, and he got it.
I didn't hear a whistle, and I'm thinking, they didn't call a foul on that? My goodness.
No harm, no foul.
DeHare will shoot 2 shots for Seton Hall. Just under 5 minutes to play, an 18-point lead for the Huskies is cut to 17, but the 18-point advantage they held just before that free throw, their biggest of the game. The University of Connecticut has really played a superb all-around game here this afternoon. Right?
Well, it's been the way they've done it this year. They've just dismantled teams with the defensive pressure. DeHare, a player we'll hear a lot from.
Scott Burrell does not get it to drop on the post pattern pass from the Dove Hennepin. Might go out of bounds, just let him down court. Burrell will go to the line to shoot 2. The foul was number 5 on Seton Hall's Franz Volsi. And Scott Burrell will go to the line for Connecticut.
Burrell, a good-looking athlete. He had arthroscopic knee surgery performed on his knee this year. Came back very quickly from it and seems to have recovered nicely.
Good-looking player, just a freshman.
He really is.
Hamden, Connecticut.
Good tools, quick, can shoot it.
5 points in the ball game for Scott Burrell. 6 points for Burrell. The UConn lead back to 18 points.
And Jim Calhoun, they've done a nice job of recruiting players of the year out of Connecticut. Burrell, Murray Williams, Chris Smith.
DeHare has it slapped away. Cooper tries to muscle up a pair, doesn't do it. Ball is kept in play. Tate George.
frustrating to try to score on Connecticut right now. There haven't been that many uncontested shots for Seton Hall in this game.
Connecticut plays terrific team defense.
Always got their hands up, making the passing lanes difficult, the open jumpers difficult.
Hennefeld is fouled as he gets sandwiched Cooper and DeHaer.
No doubt about that one.
Nadav Hennefeld will go to the free throw line.
Is charged to Michael Cooper.
Nadav has 6 points in the ball game, below his 13-point per game average in the Big East on the season. And he is an 80% free throw shooter. But JRC, 5 steals for Hennefeld.
He contributes every game. It doesn't matter if he doesn't put 20 points up. He gets in there and rebounds, and it seems that he's always picking up the steals as he's done all year long.
Hennefeld, a 20-point lead for Connecticut, their biggest of the ball game.
Well, for Connecticut, they just want to finish up strong because they know they'll have a tough test tomorrow with the winner of the Georgetown-Providence game. And for Seton Hall, for pride, just to finish up strongly in this game.
Taylor takes a three, doesn't get it. Smith has the rebound deep.
This is where Connecticut now, under 4 minutes, will start to work the clock, spread the floor, take the easy one if it presents itself. Otherwise, just make the foul shots when you go to the line.
UConn by 20. Alley-oop went off the backboard by Hennefeld.
Had to get way up there to get that one.
Too much muscle. DeHaer for three, buries the three-point shot.
That's what Terry DeHaer does at his best, hitting the jump shot. And he's really made his mark and presence this year in the Big East. Just a freshman with 3 more years for P.J. Colosimo.
3.5 minutes left in the ball game. Connecticut by 17, 68-51. Connecticut has led it all the way in this ball game. Their first double-figure lead came at halftime when they went up by 10. And they have just built on that lead in the second half. Sellers, the post-up turnaround. 3 minutes left to play. Seton Hall last year into the NCAA championship final against Michigan. This year will get knocked out in the first round of the Big East quarterfinals.
Connecticut a year ago finishes 7th in the Big East. This year the tie for first. A lot of people feel they can make a very serious run in this tournament as well as the NCAA.
Absolutely. Avent keeping the ball in play to Volsi. Doesn't get it. You see how high Burrell got that time coming through the lane, Ronnie?
Well, watch his head on the rim. He was up there so high. Rod Sellers with a little wink.
So the University of Connecticut Huskies will win this one going away at Madison Square Garden. Anthony Avent comes out of the ball game for Seton Hall. At the free throw line, Franz Volsi will shoot it. And with 2:42 to go in the ballgame, Rod Sellers goes out for UConn. Steals in the game. Connecticut, 17 steals, Ronnie Berry. They forced 24 turnovers. That is a Big East tournament record. 17 steals for UConn.
Just amazing. They've been all over Seton Hall in this game. We said one of the keys for Seton Hall would be to handle that pressure with a lot of poise. They haven't been able to do it. And for UConn, we felt they'd have to force turnovers. They have. And that's been the key to victory today.
Volsi makes it a 72-52 ball game. Only 2 minutes and 42 seconds remaining here at Madison Square Garden in this quarterfinal round. Connecticut, the conference co-champions, will advance. As you see the lead by 17, we'll be back in a moment.
Remote areas of the country can now be reached at the following number.
I like cruising downtown in my limousine. Big skyscrapers and my life scene. The rush hour traffic, we get around here. And cold Coors beer.
If you like your beer fresh, pure, and natural, head for the Rockies and the original taste of Coors.
And tap an ice cold Coors with a friend of yours.
Coors, the Rocky Mountain legend.
How do you pick a winner?
First sale of the morning's always a lucky number for me.
I do nicely playing the next train to Poughkeepsie.
I turn it to the left, I turn it to the right. I do it once again, and I could win tonight.
Show toy. Mocha.
New York Win 4. Pick four lucky numbers, and you could win up to $5,000 every day.
Toy. Going over what my Win 4.
New York Win 4. Every day's a play day.
There's the story. Turnovers for Seton Hall. They've turned it over 23 times against Connecticut and Femin back in January. Then 22. Tonight, 24. This afternoon, 24 turnovers for Seton Hall. Connecticut has committed, made 17 steals. That breaks the tournament record Villanova held back from 1986. UConn by 17. Their biggest lead was 20. Chris Smith had 14 points in the ballgame, all 14, Ronnie, coming in the first half.
Well, he's tended to score in bunches this year. Remember a game at Syracuse, we had 25 in the second half. Just a matter for Connecticut now with George and Smith and Gwynn, the three-guard lineup, to run out the clock.
Smith getting it to Burrell and back to Chris Smith. Jose Rabinbas into the ballgame for Seton Hall, trying to guard Chris Smith, which not too many people have been able to do effectively all year long in the Big East.
He lost that one, though, took his eye off it.
2:05 to go. UConn will move into the semifinal round against the winner of Georgetown and Providence. Now they split with Georgetown. They swept Providence in the regular season. DeHare into the paint and all kinds of Connecticut traffic. You know, tell you, Ronnie, sometimes it looks like UConn has seven players on the floor. They play defense so well. They slide from spot to spot so well. It sometimes looks as though there's more than five of them out there.
I know it feels that way for some Seton Hall players tonight. Everywhere they've moved, it's been traffic.
All five guys were in the paint.
Yeah, they helped out.
In the paint, all five guys were there.
The way Hennefeld helps out on that play. Tate George with the reach-in foul.
There to shoot.
Got great form shooting the basketball.
There's 16 points in the ball game as he will lead Seton Hall in scoring. Tate George, leading scorer in the game with a season-high 20 points. He's also had six steals in the game and has been the floor leader.
Got to say, his overall game has been just outstanding in this one. Look at Nadav handle it.
Well, Nadav handles it pretty well. He's a pretty good-sized kid at 6'7 and a half, 220, but he handles the ball well. He gets fouled and will go to the line.
He brought this team together this year. Early in the year, they lost their first two Big East games. And the Doug Hennefeld presence on the team has really brought everyone together.
Now, Torino Walker has come in for Connecticut. Seton Hall making changes now. Michael Cooper, the senior for Seton Hall, leads.
Nice hand for him.
Plays hard.
What a nice career for Cooper. He's had a tremendous season this year for Seton Hall. Probably game in, game out, their most consistent player. We got a nice hand here from his fans at Madison Square Garden.
Now Cooper fouls out in his final game at Seton Hall. And Hennefeld shooting 1-1, rattles the first one down.
It touched a lot of parts of the rim, didn't it?
Tough 71-55. There you see the disconsolate Seton Hall players.
Cooper was sitting next to Avent, and Avent will also be back. He's a junior.
Well, it's a 17-point lead for UConn with 1:45 remaining to be played in the basketball game. Connecticut led by 10 at the half and then broke it open. DeHare, a three, gets it.
He's quickly and quietly cutting himself 20 points.
UConn really put this one away with an early 10-2 spurt to start the second half. As Seton Hall went about 6 minutes with only one basket, and that's what killed him.
Yeah, this start to the second half, you're just kind of marveling at the way Chris Smith looked like he had a string on it, the way he gets the ball down so low. You can imagine how you could take it away from him.
Down to a minute and 10 seconds to play in the game. Tate George, 20 points, six steals in the game, just one short of the individual tournament.
Oh, good luck.
Nadav getting it to Torino Walker. That's what I mean about this Connecticut team being a very unselfish team.
Well, that's a great example of it. And Nadav Hennefeld, again, doing the little things.
Rebound, Scott Burrell. To Chris Smith with 40 seconds to play. UConn,
oof, dangerous,
will advance as Tate George just flipped it in the air. Taylor back, Down to 30 seconds to play. Connecticut will advance to the semifinal round against the winner of the Georgetown-Providence game. The P.J. Carlissimo Seton Hall team, the season is over. The Jim Calhoun's team, Ronnie Perry, the season may well be just beginning.
And could be. They're off on the right foot today with a win in the first round. It's so important to get through this game. Jim Calhoun will empty the bench
and bring in all his reserves. Five players are coming in. Actually, now let's see. But Smith at the line, so four will come in. Smith's replacement will have to wait. And Seton Hall empties the bench as well. And the University of Connecticut Huskies, who have had a Cinderella season, going from nowhere last year, seventh in the conference, up to the conference co-championship this year, will win their opening round game in the Big East tournament, big time. They lead it by right now by 16 points, but that really doesn't tell the difference in the ball game, Ronnie. It's been a 16-15 point lead most of the second half, but it's played like a 20-point lead, and they were so confident and comfortable with the lead.
Yeah, I mean, you never really thought that Seton Hall was threatening Connecticut in this game. Chris Smith was dominant in the first half, Tate George, and overall the defense has been outstanding. Seton Hall, a difficult finale. Franz Volsey, a senior, also wrapping up his career today. An outstanding one at Seton Hall. Anthony Avent will be back. He is a junior.
DeHare for Seton Hall on the miss. Rebound kept in by Seton Hall. No, rebound slapped around. Cerulic tipping it over, and Piquel loses it out of bounds. No, it went off Seton Hall. It'll be Connecticut ball.
Terry Keating almost able to get it to go down. The AD son, Larry Keating, to Seton Hall.
That is the ball game. The University of Connecticut Huskies win it by 18 points. As Jim Calhoun on the left, B.J. Carlissimo of Seton Hall on the right, the Huskies, Jim Calhoun, exchanging pleasantries at the end of this one. That's going to be the end of this basketball game. The quarterfinal matchup, the final score, the University of Connecticut 58. We'll be back with some post-game comments in just a moment.
This is MSG.
New York's the greatest city where people work hard. It's got everything all by far. The buildings, the pace, the energy too. There ain't nothing in the city that you can't do. But when it comes to chilling and farm the fall, New Yorkers take the Knicks the biggest thrill of all. Pump it up for the jamming, cause you got to see the Knicks are only found on MSG. The Knicks are home to take on the New Jersey Nets Saturday night at 8 here on MSG Network.
It's a feline fancier's dream. More than 1,000 of the world's most beautiful champion cats all gathered in one place, from the most common to the most exotic. Don't miss MSG Network's exclusive coverage as Sheba presents the 1990 International Cat Show from the Garden, Sunday afternoon at 2, here on MSG Network.
Well, there's your final score. Madison Square Garden in New York, the first game of the Big East quarterfinals, won by the conference co-champion University of Connecticut Huskies, going away 76-58. They win it by 18 points going away at the end, and they really took command, I felt, Ronnie Perry, in the final 2 minutes of the first half. They were up four. Seton Hall had made a good run at them to get to within four, and UConn hit them with that 6-0 spot to make it a 10-0 lead. I don't think Seton Hall ever recovered from that, Ronnie.
No, they didn't. They really couldn't handle the basketball in the game this afternoon. Connecticut's pressure was too much. A tournament record for steals. They were turning the ball over, Seton Hall was, and as a result, Connecticut eventually got their offense going, built that lead, that 10-point lead at halftime, which they extended with the momentum going into the second half. And as you mentioned, I don't think Seton Hall ever really seriously threatened after that point.
Connecticut started the second half with a quick 8-2 run, and suddenly they were up by 16 points, and really they never looked back after that. Tate George is our player of the game for this one, a spectacular performance, our Plymouth player of the game. Tate George, 20 points, 6 steals, and let's take a look at some of the things Tate George did in this game.
Thought he just completely took charge as the floor leader for Connecticut. He got confident early. He's been around. He's experienced. He was throwing in runners. He was stealing the basketball. playing with enthusiasm, and I thought he really elevated the level of the players along with him. I thought Chris Smith and Tate George first half were outstanding. As the game wore on, as Connecticut does it with their full court pressure, they get contributions from a lot of people.
Connecticut had a tournament record 17 steals in the game. They forced Seton Hall into 25 turnovers. Connecticut wins it going away, 76-58. The UConn Huskies are now 26-5 on the season. So along with Ronnie Perry, this is Gil Santos reminding you again our final score from Madison Square Garden, the University of Connecticut 76, Seton Hall 58. This has been a Big East Conference Television Network production.
Now you can win with the Mets. Each time you use your Mets MasterCard from Manufacturers Hanover Trust, you get another entry to the Mets MasterCard sweepstakes. And each month, there's a powerful lineup of great Mets prizes that you can win. So if you've got the card, use it. If you don't, apply now. Hey, who knows more about winning with the Mets than me? The Mets MasterCard from Manufacturers Hanover. To apply, call 1-800-MHT-METS anytime.
In a world of distractions and unexpected turns, a car should be like a friend you don't have to talk to. The Mazda 626 is actually engineered to feel just that way, resulting in an uncanny ability to make you feel in control. At the same time, it makes you feel relaxed. The 626 from Mazda. It just feels right.
Throw a party with your birthday money.
I'm putting it into a MetLife State Street Mutual Fund.
Balloons, a few friends, your big sister.
Maybe a stock or bond fund, a money market or tax-exempt fund.
Linus!
In time, I could have thousands of dollars in my MetLife Mutual Fund.
Thousands? What a party that could be.
Get Met, it pays.
Big East Tournament Telecast is brought to you by your local Chrysler, Plymouth, and Dodge dealers. And by Mercedes-Benz, engineered like no other car in the world.
Everyone, to a sold-out Madison Square Garden in New York City for arguably one of the best days in college basketball, the quarterfinals of the Big East Conference Tournament, and coming up will be a great one between the Friars of Providence College and the Hoyas of Georgetown. A look at the standings right there. Georgetown in the unfamiliar position, finishing third, Ron, 22-5 overall, and the Friars right there at the 500 mark.
Well, if Providence has done a good job against Georgetown, it's been a very competitive matchup, and this is the kind of game which I think a lot of people feel could go either way, particularly when you look at the way the game's played out this year.
And again, a couple of 90-pointers between those two teams. Should be fun here this afternoon. I'm Mike Gorman, along with Ron Perry. And again, a great day here in college basketball. Providence College basketball has been an exciting basketball that Rick Barnes has brought to this club. virtue of those two games we saw earlier tonight. The keys, though, for them coming up here.
Well, anytime you play against Georgetown, you've got to be good with the basketball. And what Providence has done is really not only broken the pressure, but attack pressure against Georgetown. They tend to shoot the ball before Georgetown can set up. They also need to have some success from deep. They can shoot the three-pointer with Carlton Screen, Eric Murdoch, Quentin Burton. A lot of people can get out there and nail it, and they have to box out against a Georgetown team, which is always a fine offensive rebounding team. And I know Rick Barnes is thinking about those things today.
You'll watch Rick Barnes work that program all day long. Inside could be key for Providence here. Conlon and Dean, the two guys.
Well, that's right. People are expecting Screen and Murdoch to be competitive from the outside, but Marty Conlon's got to play well inside with Shams Adeen. Conlon, a very good passer for a big man, and Shams Adeen looking more for his offense and rebounding as the season goes along.
And, of course, when you think of the Georgetown Hoyas, you think of pressure defense. That means Carlton Screen's got to take great care of the basketball.
And I think the second half of this year, Screen has really delivered big for Providence, handling the ball, dishing it, and scoring.
All right, again, Georgetown Hoyas, the opponents here this afternoon. Georgetown, as always, a threat to win it all in the NCAA tournament. They always play very well right here in Madison Square Garden. How about the keys for them this afternoon?
Well, you have to like the way Georgetown plays as a tournament team. Their game this year, although they're very tough inside, the perimeter important with Bryant and Tillman shooting the jump shots. Inside with Mourning and Mutombo, they can intimidate and really reject. That's why we think Conlon and Shams Adeen are important for Providence. And when they do get the break going, they must cash in. They're a good foul shooting this team. They've got to make the free throws. And John Thompson, he loves tournament time.
400 plus wins for him. And of course, two of the best big guys in the country.
Yeah, and he loves to put them out there together. He plays them separately and together. But Mutombo has really come alive, especially late in the year, offensively, rebounding. He's the leading shot blocker in the country. And Alonzo Mourning, first team All Big East, really can score the points in there, block shots. You put the two of them together, pretty tough to score on these guys.
And of course, all the ink about Mourning and Mutombo. However, there's a legitimate All-American candidate in the backcourt for Georgetown, the leading scorer in the Big East, who had some great games against Providence.
He loves to play against the Friars. 39 in each of the two games, gets the jump shot going. And when he hits his first few shots, he's a streaky hot shooter from the perimeter. He can really nail it. And his backcourt mate, Dwayne Bryant, has been putting up the points as well.
Okay, again, should be a great one here this afternoon. Two 90-point games. So, what do you expect today? More up-and-down action. The Providence College Friars and the Georgetown Hoyas are coming up at the Big East Tournament.
How do you pick a winner?
I sit down with my Harry and his clicker. Six numbers, 3 seconds flat. Thank you, dear.
The highest reading of the day. That's my method.
A six-digit total, everything on sale. It's got to be a lucky number.
4, 10.
Every Monday, somebody's six lucky numbers could win at least $100,000 in cash in New York Cash 40.
9.
New York Cash 40. Every day's a play day.
What could be more exciting than signing with the Mets? The new Mets MasterCard from Manufacturers Hanover Trust. It's got everything you'd expect from MasterCard, plus a powerful lineup of special Mets benefits.
Thanks, Mr. Johnson.
Of course, it's good just about everywhere for just about anything. You know, sometimes I wish I could use this card just to buy me a run. The Mets MasterCard from Manufacturers Hanover. To apply, call 1-800-MHT-METS anytime.
Foreman Ron Perry back out here at Madison Square Garden as a great day of basketball continues at the Big East Tournament. The Providence College Friars and the Georgetown Hoyas are coming up here with some great action.
I think for the importance of the growth of the league, that being able to take this major event into New York, largest city in the country, the major media center in the country. You know, the old song says, if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere.
You're playing in the premier arena of the world, the scholar of basketball.
And I think all of a sudden it was a case of, this is Broadway, this is big time.
It's very special. I think that if I was just a fan, I'd be tremendous weekend.
I think the fans have benefited the most because I don't know a person that doesn't go and doesn't want to go back again and again year after year. And it is something that every fan, I think, that goes looks forward to.
It's sold out months in advance. You can't get a ticket. You know, you just see people standing on the corner there scalping tickets, the chestnuts are cooking, the giant pretzels. People can't get in. You don't have that atmosphere in other places in the country.
It has a great ring to it.
when you open up a broadcast, a national broadcast, and you say, from Madison Square Garden, the Big East Championship.
At one time, in one place, to have Ewing and Mullen and Pinckney and Pearl Washington, it was a very special moment in college basketball.
Here's Chris Mullen. Yes. Mullen has 15 and St. John's by 6. David Russell has Billy Goodwin with it. It's Russell and the foul. Slam. Crowd counting it down. Garris now with 42. That's the score. St. John has defeated Boston College 85-77.
In addition to Washington's 11 points, he has 4 assists, so nearly all of the Syracuse scoring is attributable to Pearl. Now a turnover for Villanova. And the Pearl forces the steal. Here he comes. Turn it on, Dwayne. Syracuse by 5. Washington has just tied his career high with 9 minutes remaining.
Minute 20. They're not holding for one. Washington nails the jumper. Syracuse regains the lead. A career high. 30 points for the Pearl. Down to 5. Dobbs. No. Perrins the rebound. It's over. Dobbs was open. It didn't go. The Orange Men are in the final, 66-65.
One of the few big substitutes that Jimmy Boeheim has to work with.
The Pearl goes up against Ewing, and he's got it. The crowd comes to life.
You seldom see that.
Over to Alexis. The Orange Men can regain the lead as Pearl ran into Jackson. No foul called either way. Look at Pearl dribbling. Pearl stops and makes it in. The Orange Men lead by 2.
This is my city.
And Syracuse gets it back. The Pearl goes to work. 2.
Oh, big smile. 2.
After this possession, no more 45-second clock. And if Syracuse is up by 4, they may try to hold it a bit. Remember what he did against St. John's? Ewing in traffic. Hits it, and he's fouled. What a play. Jackson, we're tied. Here we go. 9 seconds to go. And we will have overtime to decide the Big East Championships. Halfway through overtime, off for Ewing, 7-point Hoya lead. They're on their way to the title.
Gary has all his shooters in there.
Comes in, Bowen!
We talked strategy. It really opened up for BC. Look at this opening that developed inside for Bowers on the pass. He shoots it. It seemed like it hung on the rim for an eternity. It was in, and then it rolled around and went out. And just look at the reactions.
On the shoulders of his team, and Joe Mullaney carried out of his last coaching. Yeah, that's a nice sight here at the Big East Tournament at Madison Square Garden. They're picking up all over the place. They pause the steal. Ewing dribbles. Jackson. Oh! Oh! High fives from the Georgetown Hoyas. Ewing heads off, hugged by his coach. He jumped in the air to give Dalton and Martin high fives. The Hoyas will head to the NCAA tournament, number one in America.
And he went up in the corner with hands in his face and stroked the jumper that was pretty as one anyone I've ever seen in my life.
Comes to glass. Now Jackson. Rowan will take it. Hit it with 8 seconds to go.
We're going crazy, but it's still time left. 20,000 people in Madison Square Garden jumping around, excited, and Pearl Washington coming down our chest. And he shakes us. We don't want to foul him. We'll let him go in the paint after a good head and shoulder move. And he goes to lay it in, when all of a sudden, he throws that left hand. And
Syracuse, no timeout. Washington, blocked by Walter Berry.
St. John's wins!
Everybody in the Garden goes crazy, and New York City is St. John's forevermore.
Douglas.
They can't handle it.
And again, Douglas waiting there at midcourt, lurking, spinning.
Points for Sherman Douglas, the ovation.
Looking, loops it in.
It ain't too far. Beckerdam's got it. Villanova, a chance to tie. Plansky will take a three. He had it! Villanova by one!
What a big one by Mark Plansky.
The ball, Lane aggressively out on him. Bryce kicks it back. Plansky for three. He got it!
Mark Plansky, Mr. Clutch here in the Big East Tournament for Villanova.
Last year, strictly a perimeter club. Now it's got all these great interior players.
Everybody's showing you something there on the interior. Matumbo is blocked, and it sets up the drop for the layup. That scoop shot gets the Tillman.
See, Brett, there's the dish.
Best weekend of college basketball outside the Final Four.
A look at a great 10 years of action here in the Big East Conference Basketball Tournament, and we'll be back noon's game right after these words from your local station.
North Star, Saturday afternoon at 2:30 here on MSG Network.
Yes, sir. Okay. Once again, everyone, to Madison Square Garden in New York, the scene for this afternoon's game between the Providence College Friars and the Georgetown Hoyas. And unfortunately, one bit of serious business we need to conduct here before this game begins. The sympathies of the Big East Conference and all its member schools go out to the families of Gregory O'Coin and Scott Lyons, two Providence College students who passed away yesterday in a private plane accident. All our sympathies are with those families today. Let's meet the starting lineups for this afternoon's game. Here's Mike Walczewski.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the second game of our Big East quarterfinal day, featuring the Friars of Providence College and the Hoyas of Georgetown. Here are the starting lineups for Providence. At forward, number 15, Quinton Burton. And for Georgetown, at forward, number 24, Anthony Allen. for Providence and forward number 25, Abdul Shamsi Dean. And for Georgetown, number 33, Alonzo Mourning. For Providence at center, number 30, Marty Conlon. And for Georgetown, number 55, Dikembe Mutombo. For Providence at guard, number 11, Carlton Screen. And for Georgetown, number 12, Dwayne Bryant. For Providence at guard, number 33, Chris Watts. And for Georgetown, number 20, Mark Tillman.